Hey guys, in this video, we are going to compare the cameras of iPhone 8 and the Xiaomi Redmi Note 5 Pro. Let's get into the comparison. We know that this comparison is not fair considering the price segment. But still, you can get an idea how the mid-range Note 5 Pro fares against the flagship. First, let's have a look at the specifications of both these cameras. The Note 5 Pro has a dual camera setup in which the primary camera is a 12-megapixel sensor with an aperture of f/2.2 and the secondary is a 5-megapixel sensor with an aperture of f/2.0. This secondary sensor is for capturing depth information. On the other hand, iPhone 8 has a single 12-megapixel shooter with f/1.8 aperture. The pixel size is slightly larger than Note 5 Pro. Coming to the front shooters, Note 5 Pro has a 20-megapixel sensor with f/2.2 aperture and the iPhone 8 has a 7-megapixel sensor with similar aperture. Under naturally well-lit situations, both the cameras perform equally good. The colors produced by the Note 5 Pro are a bit punchier, whereas iPhone produces natural colors. But the saturated pics are pleasant to look. Overall, the dynamic range on the iPhone is slightly better and the images shot on iPhone 8 is slightly on the warmer side, which looks natural. When coming to harsh lighting situations like these, clearly the iPhone is producing overall better images with good color accuracy and detail, thanks to its well-optimized software. But in this image, the iPhone 8 overexposed to the background, while subject is having more amount of detail. Under low lighting conditions, the iPhone produces low noise. Even now, Note 5 Pro doesn't seem to give up either. What's strange though is, iPhone produces brighter images while keeping the ISO and shutter speed lower than the Note 5 Pro. Coming to the macro shots, both the phones are equally good, but iPhone has a better depth of field and saturated colors with better details as well. On the other hand, Note 5 Pro also produces better images with a slight amount of detail and natural colors which do look good. The images from the front shooter is slightly better on Note 5 Pro in terms of details from shadows, but iPhone 8 also produces some good overall pictures. Moving on to the video, iPhone can shoot up to 4K 60fps, but Note 5 Pro can do only up to 1080p 30fps. Coming to the stabilization, iPhone has both optical image stabilization and electronic image stabilization, whereas Note 5 Pro has only electronic image stabilization. iPhone can also shoot slow motion videos at 1080p 240fps, thanks to the well-capable A11 Bionic chip inside, whereas Note 5 Pro can do only up to 720p 120fps. Bottom line, overall, the iPhone produces good quality images and videos as well, as it's obvious considering the price. But the Redmi Note 5 Pro is not so far, and it is one of the best camera-centric smartphones in its price segment. And it can also take some cool portrait shots like these, which the iPhone 8 simply can't because of its single camera. If you are on a tight budget and also want a good camera-centric smartphone, you can simply go with Redmi Note 5 Pro as of now. Our honest opinion is that you can go with iPhone 8 Plus or iPhone 10 if you are an iOS freak. Else, you can obviously check out some flagship Android offerings. That's it for this video guys, thanks a lot for watching. If you end up liking our content, give a thumbs up and subscribe to Tech Beyond for more. We'll catch you soon.